This is Fox 31 News.
Welcome back. It's a chilly morning outside, perfect for firing up the oven and making bread at home. Bread making can be a bit complicated, so practice, of course, makes perfect. I know I've had my own trials and tribulations. Don't be afraid, though, to get started. Joining me in the kitchen this morning is Matt Salas. He's the owner of the Great Harvest Bread Company here in Denver. Thanks for being here this morning.
Thanks for having
me. And thanks for bringing this beautiful variety of bread. So we're talking about making bread from scratch. Where do you start exactly?
Well, most important is the flour. Actually, one step before the flour is the wheat that you use.
Okay.
So I brought some wheat berries with us. They look like little grains of rice, right?
Yeah, they do.
A lot of people use white flour, which has the outer part of the wheat berry, the bran, taken off. That's where all the nutrients are.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want to strip that off. We want our flour, once we've freshly ground it, to have the little flakes of bran in it. You should see little brown spots in your flour.
Mm-hmm.
For making bread, you need the fresh flour, you need honey, yeast, salt, and water, and that's it. Those are the basic five ingredients.
Now, if somebody's at home, if they do get their hands on some of these whole grains, is there a way to grind it at home, or do you have to take that to a bakery and have them do that for you?
Well, Amazon's got a way for everything, right?
Oh, hey!
Yeah, you can order a little electric grinder. Actually, a coffee grinder would work.
Oh, really? Okay.
You might not want to brew coffee in it. Use coffee after you've put the wheat in there. But yeah, grind up your wheat and get some nice fresh flour. That's step one.
Cool.
Some nice local honey. The nice thing about local honey is the bees are exposed to the same allergens that we're exposed to.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually helps our immune system to eat local honey.
I love it.
And then I got to be honest, yeast, salt, and water, that's pretty basic.
Okay.
There's nothing special there.
Now, do you have to do the dry and then mix the wet ingredients, or how do you do all of that?
That's an excellent question. We use fresh yeast. You can tell it's fresh. If you want to take a little, you can get the pungency
that
there.
That is very pungent.
So this is very alive.
Okay.
We mix the yeast, water, some flour and honey, and salt together all in one deal. We don't do the dry and then the wet. There's a proofing process. You know,
mm-hmm.
you let the bread rise for a little while. So time and temperature is very important, but we don't separate the dry and the wet.
And then you come together with this dough, and what do you do with the dough? You have to let it rest. How do you knead it?
That's right. Again, time and temperature, you want to give it time to rise in a nice warm environment. It'll double in size if you're patient enough and if you've done it right. But then, yeah, as far as kneading, you just want to give it a little action here, give it a little shape. If you want to make a round loaf, you can turn it on its side. But this is what it should feel like.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
it's
like very webby or something.
Kind of Play-Doh-ish, wouldn't
you
say?
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah.
And then you obviously could add, like you've got different varieties here, you could add some raisins or nuts, you could add maybe spinach or other things.
That's right. I mean, if you're doing it right, what you don't need to add are chemicals or preservatives.
Okay.
The salt works perfectly as a preservative. We've added cherries and walnuts over here, spinach and feta cheese. This is honey whole wheat. That's our best seller. That's these five ingredients and nothing else. I also brought our whole grain sourdough, which is, it's the healthiest bread on the planet, frankly. It's really high in protein, it's sugar-free, low in salt, and it's actually delicious. It's my favorite as well.
Awesome. Well, we are out of time, but tell us once where you guys are located if someone did want to come get some fresh bread baked from you.
Sure. We're at 765 South Colorado Boulevard in the Belcaro Center.
All right, and I'll keep trying my hand at baking some fresh bread. And Greg, maybe I'll bring you in a loaf if I actually do it right.
You've got the sourdough starter, right?
Yeah, except I kind of think I messed it up.
Oh, no. I'll give you some of